with you.
And also with you.
We gather together on this Good Friday and invite you to join us in our call to worship. On this day, we gather to remember Jesus, our Savior, who loved us and gave himself for us. Let us draw near in full assurance of God's endless love and mercy. We give our thanks and praise to Jesus Christ, who carries our sorrows, heals our wounds, and redeems us from sin and death. We begin by singing words from Psalm 22, words Jesus himself uttered from the cross. We'll sing the refrain to begin and invite you to join between verses as marked.
Oh, shadow. In our time together today, keep us aware of your presence in the darkness. Help us to see meaning in this terrible story, and keep the fire of hope alive in our hearts. This we pray in the name of the man from Nazareth, the one who lived with a great passion for your way, the one whose death is nigh. Amen. When it was evening, Jesus took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after another, "Surely not I, Lord." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one to not have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." And he replied, "You have said so."
Shadow of impending faithlessness. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night. For it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.'" Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples.
Thank you.
one shared vigil. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me." And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "So, could you not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak."
Shadow of Christ's agony. Again, Jesus went away for the second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Again, he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners."
Speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man, arrest him." At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you are here to do." Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him.
Thank you.
exertion. Then Jesus said to them, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled." All of them deserted him and fled.
Then they seized him and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance. When they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them. Then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man was also with him." But Peter denied it, saying, "Woman, I do not know him." A little later, someone else, on seeing him, said, "You also were one of them." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." Then about an hour later, still another kept insisting, "Surely this man was also with him, for he is a Galilean." But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." At that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed. The Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly. Shadow of the cross. When they came to the place that is called the skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, while the sun's light failed. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. Please join me in our responsive prayers of the people. Giver of life, we wait with you to offer the hope that comes from the cross to the earth's darkest places, where pain is deep and affection is denied. Let love break through. Where justice is destroyed, let sensitivity to right spring up. Where hope is crucified, let faith persist. Where peace has no chance, let passion live on. Where truth is trampled underfoot, let the struggle continue. Where fear paralyzes, let forgiveness break through. Eternal God, reach into the silent darkness of our souls with the radiance of the cross. O you who are the bearer of all pain, have mercy on us. Giver of life, have mercy on us. Merciful God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Thank you.
friends, do not hurry away from the cross. Linger near to survey, to stand, to ponder our Savior's suffering and death. Consider carefully and well the preciousness of his sacrifice for you, the greatness of his mercy toward you, and then depart from Golgotha confidently, knowing that the Spirit will keep you in your crucified Savior's strong embrace and prompt you to trust and obey him always. We invite you to linger with us as we listen to the sounds of the organ and continue to reflect on Jesus' death on the cross.